Growing up in elementary and middle school, this may be out of my time, but I remember sitting in the classroom in front of the projector and watching the screen as Bill Nye, the science guy, was on television showing us cool videos about science, chemistry, biology, anything that would interest us kids to make us want to explore more, find out more about the world that we live in. And I still remember those videos till today, and my parents even do, watching them even in their adult lives. Bill Nye, the science guy, was my childhood hero. I always wanted to be a scientist because of him. Today, I'll be talking about the quote, "The more you find out about the world, the more you'll be given to laugh about it." This is by Bill Nye. My first point will be about science, which was his biggest point, and second will be about the experiences and findings that you will make as you explore the world. My first point is science. There's many fields of science. There's biology, there's chemistry, there's biochemistry. There's too much, honestly, if I'm considering it. But if you just consider it in a broad perspective, science is all about exploration. It's about finding out the smallest things in the giant world we live in. We've been studying the world for a long time now, from Aristotle, hundreds and hundreds and hundreds of years ago till today, and we still don't know so much, considering the depths of the ocean. We don't know what creatures live down there. We don't know. Maybe do mermaids exist? We don't know because we haven't gotten there yet. If we're talking about chemistry, we're talking about elements and compounds that we may not have explored yet. We're talking about explosions. We're talking about chemical reactions. There's so much that we don't know about today's world, and science is our tool in figuring that out. For example, when you consider Charles Darwin, he was a biologist a long, long time ago. He didn't figure out what evolution was, the concept that we all evolve, that we're all figuring out that our biology, that we all evolve into new beings. Charles Darwin in Australia saw a species of bird. And in his journal, when he saw the species of bird, which had a giant mohawk on it, he actually wrote, "The fact that I saw this bird made me laugh." The fact that science, his entire exploration, made him laugh in that moment is really meaning something. It means that exploration, finding something new, gives us opportunities to smile more, to laugh more. If we figure out more, we are happier. My second point is the experiences and the findings of our explorations. It may not be going across the Atlantic and doing in a billion-dollar study of the deep sea creatures. It may just be in your science lab at home. Personally, I'm taking chemistry right now. And the other day, I put two solutions in a glass vial and I made a concoction occur. And the thing fizzed up and it was honestly amazing. I laughed. It was so much fun to just see these two solutions make a little explosion in my house and just try to figure out why it happened. You don't always have to be loving the science and the process. I mean, I'm not a big believer in science, but the fact that we're finding out more about what we're trying, about the world that we live in, just makes us happier because as humans, we yearn to learn more. In conclusion, I just want to go back to middle school and elementary school. I wanted to find out the world. I was in elementary and middle school. I was not the smartest, but I wanted to be a scientist because of Bill Nye, because he was showing me that the more you find out, the happier you are, the more experiences you get, and the more you get, the more opportunities you have to laugh. It's all about keeping yourself happy and finding out about more because it is a human instinct to just want to learn more, to find out more about the world. Thank you.